Here's why I went from vegetarian to vegan. It all started about 4 years ago when I was bored one day and I decided I wanted to watch a documentary on Netflix. Down and down the rabbit hole I went. I didn't think I was gonna find anything that shocking. I'm a huge animal lover and I haven't eaten meat since I was 8 years old. I didn't see how the dairy or egg industry was harming animals. Boy, was I wrong. Here are some facts about the dairy industry. It's really so horrible. Animal abuse. Pain that these animals endure throughout their entire lives is disgusting. Maybe there are some nice farms out there in the middle of nowhere, but for the most part, this is a reality. I wanted no part of this abuse, and so from that day on, I gave up dairy.
She is now trying to change the subject.
Hi, John. I'm not actually trying to change the subject at all. I'm interested in discussing all of these things with you, because they really do matter. I think what you and I have in common is that we both want to make the world a better place, and we both really care about suffering and trying to eliminate that. Would you agree? So if that's the case, then I invite you to think about all of the animals and how they are similar to humans. They are sentient beings just like us. They feel like us. They have families like us. They don't want to be harmed. So how can we work together to help each other to make this world better, here on TikTok and out there? What do you think? Can you consider veganism?
Yes, the animals that you see at the grocery store are already killed and already packaged for you. The milk you see already comes from a cow who was raped. The eggs were already taken from the chicken. The point isn't to save the animals that are already dead. The reason that those items are there in the first place is because of consumer demand. Essentially, the reason that animal agriculture exists is because people like you consistently buy those products. If no one was buying dead bodies in the grocery store, there would be no reason to breed them for consumption in the first place. Google the following terms: supply and demand and consumer boycott. And regardless of if you think you're contributing to the industry or not, why do you see animal bodies as food? I don't know about you, but I'm not very appetized by slaughterhouse videos. I'm repulsed by them. I don't look at dogs and cats or pigs and cows and think, wow, I would love to eat you. So first of all, you have to change your mindset. And secondly, you have to think about how to boycott these industries in the best way that you can. And that's by spending money on fruits and vegetables.
I was just at the lake and I saw this young lady. She recognized me. She came up and said, "Oh, are you that vegan teacher?" And I said, "Yes." And we started talking about Bella and how healthy she looks and that she doesn't look half dead. And then she asked me if she could take a picture of me with her, a selfie, and I said, "Okay." And then, so I went kind of beside her, and then at the last second she took off her mask, or at least I think she did, because when I turned to look at her after, it was down. And I didn't say anything at the time, but I just want to say that if you see a picture of me with a young lady beside me and she's not wearing a mask and neither am I, it does not mean that I don't care about social distancing, because I do care about it. The only thing is that when I go out myself, I'm really far from everybody, so I don't wear a mask when I'm walking the streets with Bella. I don't feel a need for that, but I do wear one if I'm going to a store or something like that. So, and if you see me in public, please don't ask if you can take a picture with me, because I think it's better if I just stay away from people. Bye!
This is Bella. She's been vegan since August 2017, and look what we have. Somebody gave us this kind of dog food to try for free. We're gonna try it. It's called Vegar. It says 100% vegan pet food. And it says 30% plant-based proteins, essential amino acids, essential fatty acids, probiotics, prebiotics, herbs, sea vegetables, vitamins, and minerals. All right. Super excited to try this and see if Bella likes it. Oh, and look at it. Looks like a fun kind of shape. All right, you ready, Bella, to see if you like it? You want to try that? You like it? Good? Want some more? Oh, she likes it. All right, stay tuned, guys. We're gonna keep giving her some more of this and see how she does. I'm sure she will be fine.
was so pretty to think all along there was some invisible string tying you to me.
Might be thinking, these two circles are not equal. I repeat, these two circles are not equal. One is in fact larger than the other. What I need you to do is determine which one that is. So, please raise your hand if you believe the blue circle is larger than the red. All right. Please raise your hand if you believe the red circle is larger than the blue. All right, very good. Now, before I said anything about these two circles, what was your first instinct? Equal, right? Because they look equal. And the reason why they look equal is because, in fact, they are equal. These two circles are identical. Yet I got just about every one of you to raise your hand and say that they're not. So what do we learn? That you can be manipulated like that to believe in something that goes against your natural instinct. Just imagine, as a child, you're taught that the blue circle is larger than the red. If you say it enough times, you convince yourself that's the truth. If you're told the lie enough times, it becomes part of your reality.
And what exactly are you doing for those people starving? What are you doing? Let me guess, absolutely nothing. And how is people starving in Yemen or whatever, how does that justify you being cruel to animals? You can care about the people in Yemen and still be vegan. It's like, what? I don't get the problem. Like, why is this? Oh, but there's other things happening in the world right now, so we shouldn't respect animals. It's like, it makes no sense. Like, being vegan doesn't take away from your ability to care about humans. I just don't care about humans because that's my personality. You're not magically gonna become like me if you go vegan.
I can't respect animals because people are starving in Yemen. Like, oh my god, it's impossible to be vegan while caring about the people in Yemen. Ugh, you guys make no sense. Are you...
Because this is about the animals, not me. So I don't care if you like me or not.
You know, instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around, the ups and downs, you know, I just said, look.